Our way of life is truly on the brink right now. We cannot wait another minute for, you know, promises, pledges, something's going to happen in 20, 30 years. That will be too late. We will not be able to produce enough food for the people on this planet if we continue to wait and act as we are now. We have to become much more aggressive and bold in our actions today, not in 5 years, not in 10 years, right now, because it's already too late. Our food system is dealing with some gigantic challenges. We have over 800 million people globally that are malnourished or undernourished, and 2 billion people around the world that are overweight or obese and driving huge incidence of preventable disease like diabetes and heart disease. This just can't stand. It is a wildly inefficient system that we have a lot of work to do if we're going to solve the problems that we face. In addition to all that, food and agriculture is the number two driver of greenhouse gas emissions around the world. About 70% of the world's fresh water goes into food and agriculture. 65% more or less of biodiversity loss is directly related to our food production. And unlike energy, when you look at the emissions from food and agriculture, it's going straight up with no end in sight. Not only is food and ag driving climate change, but it's also on the front lines and is already feeling huge volatility and impact from an increasingly changing climate. It's going to be very difficult just to hold the line. It's going to be very difficult to provide nutrient-dense food for everybody at a price point that people can actually afford going forward. That is a real threat. You know, I got two kids. I got a 4-year-old and a 2-year-old. Like, they're going to enter a world where they're going to have trouble figuring out what they're going to eat and making sure that they can nourish themselves and their kids. And that's true for kids and families all over the globe. The United Nations Food Systems Summit, I believe, is a real watershed moment for these issues. For a long, long time, people have been, you know, screaming from the rooftops, largely on deaf ears, that, you know, our food system is at the core of both human and environmental health, and that we needed to elevate it, especially in the climate change discussion, to a level that it hadn't been. We got a lot more work to do to continue to push and understand more deeply that relationship and what we have to do from a food system to make sure that we're not driving climate change and we're also ready to deal with it. You know, I, like many old people, are definitely inspired every time you talk to younger generations on these issues. They get it. They understand the issues on climate and what's at stake. They understand that we have to start new businesses, run for office. They're doing the work, and we need to continue to create more room for them to do the work. But if I hear one more old people say the kids are gonna save us, I'm gonna lose my mind. Like, it is on all of us. We created this problem, not them. They're dealing with it. But we cannot just turn the keys over and say, oh, we're so hopeful because some young people are speaking out. That's garbage. Fundamentally, one of the things we have to do, particularly in Western nations, is to eat less meat, particularly less red meat. It is by far the biggest driver of greenhouse gas emissions in the food system, and we just are overconsuming it in astronomical amounts. So, doesn't mean you have to become a vegan. I will never be a vegan. All love to the vegans, but we gotta reduce how much animal-based protein we're consuming. That right there is a huge start. We gotta waste less. Of the 40% of food that's wasted in the United States, 40% of that, it comes from our homes. It's not upstream. Being more deliberate about having a plan for what we're gonna make during the week is very helpful, as opposed to just buying a bunch of stuff, not knowing what you're gonna do with it. In the end, we're gonna need both our business leaders and our politicians to fundamentally do a better job than they've been doing. They've been failing us on these issues, point blank. So if our dollars start supporting companies that really care about this stuff, everybody else is gonna follow. So we have a lot of power in how we spend our money. And then, of course, it's how we vote. As messy as it is, and after 6 years in the White House, I know it's a messy, messy game. It works, though. We simply have not been demanding and voting on climate and health-related issues. We just haven't. If we want our politicians to go big on these things, we have to tell them, either you do this or you're out. And trust me, they don't want to be out. So they're going to do it if they know that their seat in office depends on it. I will just say, get involved. This isn't going to change from our couches. Do some work and see who's doing great work in your community. Reach out, volunteer, join, get your voice out there. Start engaging on these issues. We have no more time to waste. And if we take collective action and we follow up on the UN Food System Summit and take the framework that will be put out, I actually think we could mitigate most of what awaits us. I think we could get ourselves on a fundamentally better path. Not a perfect path. A lot of this is already going to play itself out, and it's going to be a difficult number of decades ahead. But we can avoid the worst of this if we really start going to work as a society collectively.